Hello everyone, welcome you all to the Technical Talk series. Myself Chandana, Assistant Professor of Department of Civil Engineering at Vedavyasa Institute of Technology. So today I'm going to present on the topic pre-stressed concrete. We all know that concrete makes one of the most important constituent for construction of structures around the world. But despite of its exceptional properties, it has few important weaknesses also. First one is that even though it is strong in compression, it can almost not take tension. Then the other main problem is that concrete is brittle in nature. So due to these two problems, it can result to crack formation in the concrete structures. Over the years, there are several types of concrete introduced. Pre-stressed concrete is one of a kind which are now widely used and has several advantages to overcome this crack formation and to increase the serviceability of structures. So now let's see what is a pre-stressed concrete. So basically, when load acts on the beam of a structure, there will be compression in the top portion and tension in the bottom portion of the beam. Since concrete is weak in tension, cracks start to generate at the bottom of the beam, as you can see in this picture, left part of the first picture. And then these cracks and deflection, this crack formation and the deflection can be reduced to an extent by reinforcing beam by providing bars, reinforcement bars, which can take in tension. This is the conventional method used widely, that is providing tension reinforcement bars in the concrete to take tension. But even then, cracks still develop in the reinforced concrete due to incompatibility in the strains of steel and concrete. Hence, the development of pre-stressed concrete. So, in this type of concrete, that is pre-stressed concrete, internal stresses of suitable magnitude are introduced prior to the service, and these stresses which are introduced to the concrete, these contracts the stresses resulting from the external load. So as the name says, that is pre-stress, they are concrete in which we apply stresses to the structural member prior to its service. Okay, this is accomplished by this providing stresses. This is accomplished by tendons, which is a stretched element. These tendons are used to impart pressure to the concrete. So basically it is that to carry the load, to carry the external load, we are providing internal stresses priorly. So in this picture, this picture of an RCC slab, it is a reinforcement laid for conventional reinforced concrete slab. And the next picture shows arrangement for pre-stressed slab. You can see that yellow color, those are the tendons. Anchorages are used to enable these tendons to impart and maintain pre-stress in concrete. So there are various types of tensioning devices which are used for tensioning this steel. They can be either mechanical tensioning, hydraulic tensioning, electrical or chemical. Now let's look into the pre-stressing systems, how they are done. There are generally four types of pre-stressing system. First one is pre-tensioning. That is, tension is provided to the tendons before the concrete is poured. Before the concrete is poured to the structure. Then the next type is post-tensioning. So in post-tensioning, the tension is provided, or the stress is provided to the tendons after the concrete is set. Then the third type is thermoelectric pre-stressing. In this method, the stress is provided by heating the tendons, which is achieved by passing an electric current in the high tensile wires. Then the fourth method is chemical pre-stressing. It is also known by the name self-stressing. Okay, this is made possible by the use of expanding cements, but this method is not suitable for high degrees of pre-stress and it's not commonly used. Let's look into how post-tensioning of a slab is done. So this shows the structure, and let's go back to an initial form. So let's take the ground floor slab on top of the column. Formworks are laid. As you can see, the formworks are laid, and then the reinforcement are laid as per the design. It is the conventional reinforcement that is provided here initially. It is just that steel reinforcement is given. And then we set up the anchorage assembly. That is, first we place a pocket former, then the anchorage and the holder nails. So anchorages are provided wherever the tendons are required to be tightened. And then these are the tendons. We use strands for providing the stress in the concrete. So this is blue color shows the tendons. They are greased to reduce the friction, and all the tendons are laid as per the design. So the post-tensioning can be done either bonded or unbonded. Okay, that is, bonded means the concrete, the pressure is imparted to concrete through the bond between the tendons and the surrounding concrete. Now non-bonding shows the method of construction in which tendons are not bonded to the surrounding concrete. So here, as we see, after the concrete is set, so in post-tensioning, the stress in steel is provided after the concrete is set. So after the concrete is set, we remove the pocket and the residue of the concrete is removed, and then we place the wedges, as you can see in the video. And then a marking is given. As you can see, the yellow color marking is given so that to mark how much the tendons are stretched. Now the pressure stress is given, they are pulled, and our action takes place. So you can see the yellow mark has moved due to the stressing. The yellow marks have moved. Then the additional part is removed. So that is about So now let's look into the famous structures in which pre-stressed concrete are used for constructions. So the Sydney Opera House and the CN Tower, Toronto, Eureka Tower in Melbourne, Ocean Heights. There are several structures which have been constructed by pre-stressed concrete. These are some of the few which I've shown in these pictures. Okay, so that's a brief about pre-stressed concrete. Hope you have got a bit of information about it. Thank you for watching. Thank you, everyone.